Hello everyone, welcome to this session. I am Priyanka Bansode and today we are going to study about working of Tachogenerator. These are the learning outcomes of this video lecture. At the end of this session, students will be able to explain construction, principle and operation of Tachogenerator and explain types of Tachogenerator. These are the contents we'll be covering in this session. Now, before moving towards, pause this video for few seconds and you have to think and write the difference. Do you know the difference between tachometer and tachogenerator? Let us see the difference between tachometer and tachogenerator. So first, tachometer consists of tachogenerator. And tachogenerator is usually referred as permanent magnet DC brush generator. Then next, a tachometer is just a display for human readings and a tachogenerator can be a part of control loop. Then next, a tachometer is an instrument that measures and displays rotational speed, but tachogenerator is an electric generator that generates a voltage that is accurately proportional to the speed of the shaft. Now we will see in detail about tachogenerator. The word tachogenerator comes from the Greek word tacho. So tachogenerator consists of two words, that is tacho plus generator. In Greek, tacho means speed. And the generator means an instrument which generates power. So here the figure shows the tachogenerator and shaft. Tachogenerator is a device which is used for measuring the speed of shaft and converting this speed into a voltage so that it can be measured. So voltage is measured through this voltmeter. Common voltage signal used with tachogenerators is 0 to 10 volts. Now we see the types of tachogenerator. There are two types of tachogenerator. So first AC tachogenerator and second DC tachogenerator. First we see about AC tachogenerator. The AC tachogenerator is a small brushless alternator with a rotating multipole permanent magnet. In AC tachogenerator, the armature is provided with an AC winding, either single phase or three phase windings. And the output voltage is measured by a voltmeter, although the varying frequency will affect the accuracy of this instrument. Now, we see the construction and working of AC tachogenerator. So here the AC tachogenerator consists of permanent magnet, then rectifier for converting AC output into the DC, then smoothing circuit moving coil voltmeter and the rotor where the speed is to be measured. When the rotor is stationary, no EMF is induced in the output winding and primary winding excited by an AC input voltage. The induced voltage in secondary is zero. Due to relative position of two windings being placed at 90 degrees to each other. Then as the rotor rotates, a voltage is induced in the secondary winding whose magnitude is proportional to the rotor speed. And then EMF is induced in the quadrature coil and this EMF is directly proportional to the rotor speed. So here the equation is Vt is equal to Kt phi of t, where Vt is the voltage and phi of t is the rotor speed and Kt is nothing but it's the tachogenerator constant and is in phase with applied voltage to the reference coil. Now we see about DC tachogenerator. A DC tachogenerator is a small DC generator which has to generate electrical voltage corresponding to the speed of rotating machine. Then the produced voltage is dynamically induced EMF. Dynamically induced EMF means what? When the conductor is in motion and the field is in stationary. And EMF is induced in the conductor, and this type of EMF is called dynamically induced EMF. The requirement of this EMF is to establish necessary flux in the field, and also system of conductors is required so that a relative motion between the flux and the conductor create rate of change of flux linkage and generate the DC voltage. So the field system may be in the form of electromagnet or permanent magnet, and it is stationary part of the DC tachogenerator. So now we see the construction and working of DC tachogenerator. So here the DC tachogenerator consists of permanent magnet, moving coil voltmeter and shaft for speed measuring, same as the AC tachogenerator. But here no need of rectifier because already output is in DC form. Then the series resistance is used to limit the current under output short circuit condition. Then the polarity of output voltage indicates the direction of rotation. Then the commutator collects the current from the armature conductors and converts internally induced AC EMF into the DC EMF. Then brushes are used to collect current from commutator and make it available to external circuitry of the DC tachogenerator. So this is the construction about the DC tachogenerator. Actually, DC tachogenerator is based on the principle of Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. According to the law, when a conductor moves in a magnetic field, it cuts the magnetic lines of force, due to which an EMF is induced in the conductor. We know that the magnitude of induced EMF depends upon the rate of change of magnetic flux linkage with the conductor. Now we see the working principle of DC tachogenerator. So first, the armature of DC tachogenerator is kept in a permanent magnetic field, and the armature of tachogenerator is coupled to the machine whose speed is to be measured. When the shaft of the machine revolves, the armature of the tachogenerator also revolves in the magnetic field, producing EMF, which is proportional to the product of flux and speed to be measured. As the field of permanent magnet is fixed, the EMF generated is proportional to the speed directly, and this generated EMF is measured using moving coil voltmeter. Now we see the difference between AC and the DC tachogenerator. So first difference is, in AC tachogenerator, speed is measured only in one direction, and in DC tachogenerator, speed is measured in both directions. Then next, in AC tachogenerator, rectifier is needed because here we have to convert AC output into the DC. But in DC tachogenerator, already output is in DC form, so no need of rectifier. Then next, here ripples are reduced in AC tachogenerator and small ripples are appearing at the output in DC tachogenerator. And then the last one, maintenance is difficult in in AC tachogenerator and maintenance is easy in DC tachogenerator. So these are the some points between the AC tachogenerator and the DC tachogenerator. Now we see the advantages of tachogenerator. First, it is simple in construction and design. Then it is not expensive. It has a linear relationship between output and the rotational speed. It requires less maintenance and temperature compensation is also simple. Advantages of tachogenerator. So first, it is limited to low speed and tachometers are hard to calibrate. These are the applications of tachogenerator. So first is measuring rotating speed of disc or shaft. This is the main application of tachogenerator. Then it is used in automobile speedometer. It is used in industries and rail for controlling motor and speed respectively. These are the some references of this video lecture. Thank you.